is Burger King coming? And I just, I had heard about the question. You know, the mayor now has a new planning commissioner, and we're hoping that with that person in place, that the planning board will be, and you still give them the opportunity to, maybe we can't get it, not to stop it from coming, but we can make some allowances so that the traffic, maybe we can push it off of that busy Columbus Sanford and make it go out the back way. I mean, that's part of the planning board's, what they do, correct, when people come into the city. But certainly, thank you for bringing it to our attention. Now, several of you spoke about the conflict between the city council and the mayor. Now, that's not new. From Mayor Blackwood, from Mayor Davis, from Mayor Young, that historically, that has been here. But in this day and age, because of social media, you know, a lot more is, you know, a lot more is shared with the public. Now, these disagreements have gone on forever. And they probably will continue because they exactly like you say, they have checks and balances, and that's what you know, America was founded on. The legislative branch, we're primarily legislative, as Dr. Bastamil said, but we do have other powers, but we're primarily legislative. And with that such, Ms. Reed, I'm gonna jump around on mine. Ms. Reed, I agree with everything that you said. And one of the things that we can look at in terms of these zombie businesses is to work with it. Develop legislation, and I was playing out in my head when we were talking about with the insurance companies after these fires to rectify these so that the city may not be liable, but the insurance company rectifies the situation so we don't have to look at these businesses forever. And I think in the case of Sal's Deli and that, I think that's why theirs move so fast, and we got to look at doing that all around the city. So that's one of the things we can do as a city council, work with them. And that's important because no one wants to look at. Particularly, you don't want to look at burned out buildings, but to see businesses, you got beautiful businesses, and then you go down and you see, you know, like you call them zombie businesses, which they are, and we certainly don't want to see that. We want our city to be beautiful, and it is. And we have to promote the positive. And where we may not always agree with Mayor Thomas, and let me say this for the record, but we all have meetings with them. We don't always publicize, we talk to each other. But that doesn't mean we agree, we do communicate. We know we don't have to, you know, as you say, sleep together. But there might be differences, even on this council, there are several differences. We usually don't say about here, but there are several. We had a 1 o'clock in the morning last night. Most of our committee meetings go to 12 and 12:30, and these Tuesday night meetings and Mondays, because we hash it out amongst each other, and that's important. But with these five distinct people, that's going to happen. And with the mayor, it's going to happen. And we're gonna work through, but there's going to be differences. And, you know, we'll build, we all want the city to be better. And we can't, you know, we gotta find middle ground. And it's not gonna be easy, because we're all very strong, minded people. And we have visions that we gotta bring together. And it's gonna take time, it's gonna be growing pains, but we're gonna get there. Dr. Vasquez, I wanna thank you for your document. Obviously, we didn't have a chance to look at it, but I look forward to perusing it. As far as I know, I've heard talk of 50 zombie homes, but to my knowledge, we don't have a list of them. So I wish we could get more, but as far as we know, we haven't seen a list to that effect. But again, even with those homes, we have to work with these insurance companies. We have to develop a way that the city doesn't have to put out all these funds ahead of time and wait for it to come back, that we work with these companies so that they take care of the. That's why you have insurance, because they're supposed to rectify it within a certain amount of time. Let's see. And Mr. Gaines, he left, but I thought he had good ideas in terms of maybe an ATM or it was discussed some time ago, and I don't remember what happened. I left, and since I don't know whatever happened with the ATM and using credit cards and debit cards, but this is not the first. This came up maybe 15 years ago. About it. It did. I mean, there's a policy, there's things that have to be done, but we have to work with our controller to make that happen. That's where we're going to have to square with her. Something else I wanted to. And also, I know Commissioner Kelly last night, he spoke about the legislation, his proposal about cameras and stuff. We didn't actually see the legislation, he spoke about it. But as a former city clerk, there are some privacy issues in the city clerk's office and the registrar's office birth and marriage records and those kind of things, when you're getting a record, it's not public. Those records are not public. So we have to find balance. And certain things, I don't think should be, you know, should be public. The hallway, well, anyway. Once we get the actual request, then we'll be able to amend it to make it, to try to make it work for everyone. But there are some issues that we have to protect people coming in doing private business too. So it's a balance. And this, you spoke on the CCRB, that's going to take, it's going to take time to get it right. You know, I know it seems like it's taking a long time, but it's still only March. So we've been in discussions, and I know Councilman Edwards has been in discussions with the commissioner since the first meeting when you brought it up in January. I remember he's been meeting with them. We do need input, as it said, from the police department to make it work, but we still will control it. I envision, and I'm sure that Councilman Wallace and Edwards envision it being led by the people, the community. And the newspaper article regarding former Commissioner Bobe was disappointing. And I think that's all I'll say on that. And I will conclude my remarks. And I'd like to wish you all to celebrate a happy Easter this coming weekend. Be safe. Thank you.